Pointman is a seated user interface for dismounted infantry simulation. Although it was designed to provide squad-level training in a traditional classroom setting, we believe that Pointman gives users more effective control over their avatar than more expensive dismounted infantry simulators. The Immersive Simulation Section at the Naval Research Laboratory developed the Pointman user interface. This video explains how it works.
Pointman is a seated user interface which uses a head tracker, gamepad, and sliding foot pedals to very precisely control the movement of one's avatar through a virtual environment. We've integrated Pointman with Virtual Battle Space 3, and I'll be using that simulator for my demo. I like to start out in my demo in third-person mode so that you can see more clearly the effect of the control on my avatar, which you see on the screen in front of me. The head tracker consists of a camera mounted to the monitor and LEDs that are attached to my head. They track the position and rotation of my head and upper body so that I can, as you can see, as I move my head up and down, side to side, my avatar's motion of his head and body mimic mine one for one. So I can lean into a deep hunch, look around, and we use this for looking and aiming and taking effective use of cover. The foot pedals are used to control stepping, the sliding motion. As I push forward with my right foot, notice that my avatar correspondingly steps with his right foot so that I can very accurately control the size and cadence of my stepping. We direct the motion with the thumbsticks on the gamepad. When I push the left stick to the left and step, now I'm going to sidestep in the direction that I'm pushing with the thumbstick, back and to the right. The right stick controls turning, the direction the avatar faces, which allows me to walk in a curved path. The foot pedals also go up and down like the accelerator pedal of your car, and we've mapped that into a continuous control over the postural height. So as I push down on the pedals, notice my avatar goes into a deep crouch. If I take a step and go down, my avatar can take a knee. And of course, while I'm crouching or at any level in between, I can step using the foot pedals. A button on the gamepad is used to go into a prone position. And once I'm prone, here my feet are up, high prone, hands and knees. As I press down on the foot pedal, notice my avatar goes into low prone, belly to the ground. And of course, while prone, I can crawl using the controls. And while I'm prone, notice that I can still control the direction I'm looking and the lean of my torso using my upper body. The gamepad also has tilt sensors, and we've mapped this into a fluid control over the weapon hold. As I'm holding the gamepad in a tilted down position, my avatar is holding the rifle in a lowered position. As I tilt up the gamepad, notice the weapon comes up into a low ready aim all the way to a high ready position. The side-to-side tilt of the gamepad we've mapped into a continuous control over the weapon roll. Being able to control the weapon in this manner is very important for tactical operations, especially being able to quickly bring the weapon into a lowered position to move through tight spaces, avoid muzzle sweeping your comrades, leading with the rifle around corners. Let me go into first person. Show you how I can take advantage of the cover offered by this wall. Go third person. So notice how I'm aiming. And while I'm aiming, let me make a note. Notice that with the sight picture, I'm able to finally control my aim using my head, okay, to target. I'm going to do a quick little mission here. There are some bad guys, so I have to move tactically along this wall by the corner. They do shoot back. As I move into the courtyard, notice how carefully I can adjust my pace through the environment. As I come up behind this truck, go third person, notice that I'm leaning forward and crouching down. My feet are pressing down on the foot pedals to take advantage of the cover. And as I slowly come up, I see an enemy in the distance. Again, using my head for fine control over aiming. There's one more bad guy that I have to take care of over here. A few more comments about aiming. Let me move into the intersection. The cursor that you see in the center of the screen is a view cursor. It's not an aim cursor. It depicts the center of the screen and where the sight picture will be when I bring up the aim. Okay, if I shoot with the weapon lowered, notice where the bullet hits. Of course, in close quarters, you can use that to effect. We use all the various fire modes offered by VBS3, so I can cycle to a three shot burst, bring up the M203 grenade launcher. Notice that I'm still aiming, fine control over aiming with my head. And then to finish, I'll just simply lob a grenade. The aim trajectory is actually provided by VBS3 as an optional assist. And that's the end of my demo. Thank you.
The Immersive Simulation Section at the Naval Research Laboratory has developed several user interfaces for dismounted infantry simulation over the past decade. First, we developed a full-body tracked interface where the user wore a head-mounted display and wielded a realistic rifle prop. It was called Gator because the user steps in place to move through the virtual world. Later, we took what we learned developing Gator and applied it to create Pointman. We believe that Pointman gives users even more effective control over their avatar for infantry simulation. Our goal has always been to make dismounted infantry simulation more realistic. In time, we realized that this means to better represent what the user would do in the real world. And this boils down to giving the user more direct and extensive control over his avatar. The key actions involved in infantry combat are looking, moving, shooting, and communicating. Since dismounted infantrymen are not heavily armored, they must make use of cover and concealment. Being able to quickly move to cover and use it effectively is critical for realistic infantry simulation. The Pointman user interface adds a precision head tracker and sliding foot pedals to a gamepad controller. This makes for a compact, low-cost system. Our software maps the user's actions to provide more natural and extensive control over the avatar. Pointman engages the user's head, hands, and feet to control corresponding segments of the avatar's body. This offloads the hands from having to control the entire avatar. The user can easily coordinate the movements of his head, hands, and feet to move the avatar with freedom and precision. You don't need a head-coupled display to do head-coupled viewing. We simply couple the avatar's head movements to the user's and show what the avatar would see on the screen. When the user moves his head, the avatar's head moves with it. Unlike interfaces that exaggerate turning the head to present a wider field of regard, Pointman applies a one-to-one mapping. This affords precise aiming since the gun sight moves with the head. All the new channels added to Pointman provide positional control over the avatar's posture. A positional control ties the position of an output directly to the position of an input device. Inputs from gamepads used in console games are applied as either discrete or rate controls. A rate control ties the speed of an output to the position of an input device. A discrete control triggers a specific change in the output. In terms of animating a character, with a discrete or rate control, you press a button or push a stick, and the system plays out a canned motion sequence. That's how today's first-person shooter games work. Positional controls are a game changer. With positional controls over the avatar's posture, the user moves the avatar by continuously varying its posture. The user controls the avatar's posture with the same dexterity as he positions his head, hands, and feet. And the user constantly feels the avatar's posture without the need for visual feedback. Moreover, the set of controls collectively determine the avatar's posture. This allows the user to naturally coordinate his movements while the avatar simply reflects that motion. Thank you for viewing our video. For further information, please refer to the Pointman User Interface Wikipedia page.